Hello dear Steamians, YouTubers, members of Uptrend, and all beautiful and creative blockchain people. That's me again at CryptoSpa, and this is my next cryptocurrency market overview. So let's start. Let's have a look at the price of the major cryptocurrencies according to the beautiful site of CoinGecko. And we see that the market has registered a slight price decrease for the last 24 hours. Most of the major cryptocurrencies have declined in value, in price actually, and it means that their prices have been trading sideways for the last, let's say, 2 or 3 days. So it's a kind of consolidation after the solid price decrease. I want to say that on Monday I analyzed the price chart of Bitcoin in details, then I analyzed the price chart of Steam yesterday. Today I would like to analyze the price chart of EOS. So let's have a look at the price chart of EOS. And this is actually the current price of EOS. As I have mentioned before, I would like to analyze the price charts of the major cryptocurrencies if measured by market capitalization. That's why I want to analyze today the price chart of EOS. And the current price is $3.05, and EOS has registered a 2.4% decrease for the last 24 hours. This is actually the daily chart of EOS against the USD. Let's start with the broader picture. Let's have a look at the monthly time frame. And I want to say that to some extent, the monthly chart of EOS is quite similar to the ones of Bitcoin, Litecoin, etc. So I mean that we had a solid price increase in the first half of 2019, followed by a price decrease in the second half of 2019. Then we had a kind of hammer candlestick in December of last year, followed by a solid bullish engulfing. So this is the bullish engulfing candlestick pattern. And after the bullish engulfing in February, on the monthly time frame, we had this shooting star. So we know that the shooting star, if confirmed by the next candlesticks, it may turn out to be a solid bearish candlestick or pattern presaging trend reversal. And so far on the price chart of US, it seems that we have a confirmation, or we are going to have a confirmation of this shooting star, because I'm saying that we are going to have, because it is still the beginning of, or the middle of, the current month, and we don't know how the candlestick, or this candlestick for the month of March, will look like at the end of the month, or I mean at the very beginning of next month. That's why if we assume that we have a candlestick like this, it will be a confirmation according of the shooting star, according to the this candlestick pattern. So in this way, it means that the bears are trying to push further down the price. And if we switch to the weekly time frame, it is quite possible that the price will test this local low. Actually, it is already almost there, so it is testing this local low. So this is the local low. And chartists, they usually consider the previous local lows as support ranges or support levels. So in our case, it may turn out that if the price continues to decline, it may receive some kind of support within the range of the previous local low. By the way, the logic or the situation of Bitcoin and the price chart of Bitcoin on the Litecoin is quite similar. That's why it's because of the solid correlation between the major cryptocurrencies. I mean, because of the solid correlation between the prices of the major cryptocurrencies, not the ecosystem of the major cryptocurrencies. That's why I want to say that it may turn out that here the price of US may receive some kind of support. But if we have a look at the weekly charts, we have a continuation or a sequence of candlesticks. So it is easily recognizable that we have this sequence of candlesticks with descending local highs and descending local lows. That's why I consider it as a bearish signal or a bearish sentiment. And in this case, I'm not going to open a long position. So if we switch to the daily time frame, we have the price chart is not that indicative or more indicative if compared to the one on the weekly time frame. But the thing I would like to point out is that it is visible, or it is easily visible, the downtrend. So we have this downtrend here. Let me change the color of the lines. So this is actually that downtrend, and it is even more visible on the 4-hour time frame. So this is the downtrend. We have this sequence of descending local highs and descending local lows. So it means that the bears are prevailing over the bulls in the market. And in this case, it is quite dangerous to try to catch some local low if there is no reversal signal, as in our case. And the next thing I want to mention is that if we switch to the weekly time frame, the situation is very important. We are at a very critical point, because so far we have this sequence of local lows that are ascending since the, let's say, inception of EOS. So this is one of the local lows in 2017, this is a local low in 2019, and this is a local low that was at the end of 2019. And so far we have this sequence of ascending local lows, and this is very critical moment, I say, because if the price chart of EOS records or hits a local low that will be lower than the previous local lows, it will break, let's say, this sequence of ascending local lows. So it will break the uptrend, the global uptrend of US, and the situation may become very dangerous, let's say, for the price of US. But of course, keep an eye on this trend line, it may turn out that in the longer run we may witness some kind of price rebound from this trend line. So I will keep an eye on this trend line, because I think this is a very important line and we're in a very interesting situation. That's it for today, fellas, about the price of EOS. Thank you for watching my analysis. Please share your view as a comment under this video. Of course, I wish you a wonderful day and hope to see you in the next one. It was me at CryptoSpa.